Rolling.
Cool.
Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go.
The chorus feels good. The verses feel a little slow.
Heading to the first day back into the studio since making Self-Made Man.
Today is the first day of the covers album, yet to be named.
Hey, why not? Let's make another record.
Wes Tooley from AEA.
Okay.
Loaned me a couple of new mics called a KU5. And these two mics that I have, you guys have actually used these exact mics. These mics.
Oh, where? At the Grammys?
Yeah.
You know what, y'all? Thank God for AC. It's nice, right?
Day two in the studio. Day one went really well.
Tracked a lot of vocals, a lot of guitars. Megan was just shredding. She played some incredible stuff yesterday.
Jumping back into the saddle, like almost immediately after Self-Made Man, it's a lot easier to record this time around, so that's fun. But hopefully today will go as well. I'll have to report back, but I'm super excited.
We are working at a clip.
At a real clip.
You look like an angle.
It's like in geometry and acute.
Yeah.
Day four of five here in the studio. We are having a blast. We are having so much fun. Megan, how are you feeling?
Stellar.
I think my favorite song to record so far, I think, is Devil in Disguise.
But really, all of them have been pretty fun so far.
I can't remember when we would have gotten this print. It's like a print of Megan live and like early Larkapotes, maybe even Level Sisters days. And it's like a poster-sized print, and we were going to throw it away, but instead Megan brought it to Roger as a gift. And so now anybody who's peeing in the bathroom has Megan kind of like judgily watching them pee. I need to wait for her to come out so I can show you.
So hey! This is Megan coming out of the bathroom,
show us the poster,
but maybe Megan is actually still in the bathroom.
Yes!
Day five of five. Wow. The time has really flown by.
Last day in the studio, finishing up this record.
It's been so nice. Every day of, quarantine, where there has been limited schedule, to finally like have a return to schedule and like waking up with somewhere to go. So that's pretty awesome in and of itself, even outside of the fact that we're just getting to play music and, you know, joke and have fun together with Roger and Mega. I've been having a great time. But, you know, I wouldn't trade it for anything. And that's it. I guess this is the last one of these I'll be doing. Pulling up the studio now. We're going to make today count.
So as it turns out, this is where the story of Kindred Spirits actually starts.
At the end of 5 days in the studio, we left with 10 fully fledged out finished songs. Roger had engineered the ever-loving fire out of these tracks. They sounded amazing, but in listening to them, It was a real heart-to-heart conversation that Megan and I had about whether or not these recordings actually accomplished what it was that we'd set out to create.
It's a gut feeling you get, and the gut feeling that we were getting was that something was missing, and what was missing was the chemistry between the two of us.
Mm-hmm.
The two of us playing live in a room together. So we decided we needed to make the album again, and this time, record it live.
So welcome to chapter 2 of The Making of Kindred Spirits, the chapter where we actually make the record.
Hey!
Hey!
Welcome to day one!
Here we go again!
Again!
Let's try it again! I feel like we're still, I'm pushing and pulling on the timing coming out of the choruses.
Like I've said before, I really think that's part of the beauty of it. We're finding that we're using our, like, first or second or take, and then we're, like, doing it again and again, and really the magic is kind of there, you know?
Well, let's listen then. Let's listen.
Moogle son, see my flip-flops?
You want me to go back where I was?
Yeah, I'm gonna listen to it real quick.
I don't know, I like it. I like having a studio in my house because it's like an alcoholic living in a bar. You know?
Oh, God.
Our good friend Roger Allen Nichols, who the girls have worked with a lot, is my best friend in the world. And I have been taking notes, watching over his shoulder for years. And it's awesome to be able to put some of those into use.
For joining us on this journey of making Kindred Spirits. It wound up being a lot more of an emotional and twisty-turny journey than we could have ever imagined. And to be honest, at the beginning of this whole experience, we were in two minds as to whether or not we actually wanted to tell the story of this false start into the actual making of, because, you know, none of us like to share our missteps. But I think it's very important to note that missteps are as much a part of the journey as the true steps.
It's so important to follow your gut. And that's what we did with this one. And we're very proud of the way that Kindred Spirits came out in the end. And we hope you enjoy it as well.
It's yours now. Deal with it, guys.
I remember when Rock was young.